Hello students, in this video we are going to study our next chapter, that is chapter number 9. The chapter name is Learn. Class 5, subject EVS, GCERT. We know that we are living on the land, but now what are the different components of the land? Which kind of soil, or you can say land, are there? So different types of the soil, then after different components of the soil or land, about that we are going to study in this chapter. So now let me start here. One reading section is given to you. So now let me start reading. Madan Bhai, after taking his dinner, sat for watching TV. One man is there whose name is Madan Bhai, and after taking the dinner, he was sitting for watching the TV. The baby Zin came running to him. She said, "Grandfather, tell me a story." Now this Madan Bhai has one granddaughter whose name is Jill. Now this Jill is coming towards him and saying that, "Grandfather, tell me one story." So now that Madan Bhai is asking to her, "Which story do you want to listen?" So the Jill is saying, "The one which I enjoy the most." The Jill is saying that, "Tell me the story which I enjoy the most." So the Madan Bhai is saying that, "Okay," and he began the story. So here one story is given to you. So now let me also read this story. There was a small village. A porter named Madan Bhai stayed here. One village was there, and a man who is porter by profession, that means who is making the ports from the clay, is living in that village, and his name was Madan Bhai. Every day he brings soil from the lake and prepares pots, bowls, etc. Every day he is bringing the soil from the lake, or you can say clay from this lake, and then after he was preparing pots, bowls and any other items which are made up of clay, like toys, then after bowls, saucers, etc. One day he prepared a small pot and he painted it colorful, so the pot looked very beautiful now. One day he prepared one pot and then after he colored that pot. You know that nowadays the pots are also available with different colors and designs. So he also painted that pot, and after the painting that pot was looking very beautiful. He kept the pot in his shop for sale, and the next day Ramesh Bhai was passing near by his shop. This porter Madan Bhai has also one shop, and after preparing that pot, he put that pot on his shop for selling. And on the very next day, one another man was there whose name was Ramesh Bhai. He was passing to the shop of that Madan Bhai. He saw the pot and immediately purchased it. His daughter became extremely happy after seeing this small pot in Ramesh Bhai's hand. So Ramesh Bhai also liked that pot, and immediately or suddenly he purchased that, or he buy that pot. And after that he was going home. He reached the home, and at home his daughter also liked that pot, and he became very happy after seeing that pot in Ramesh Bhai's hand. She said, "Papa, I will fill water in this small pot." So now what she will do to that pot? She is saying that, "Papa," to her father, that she will pour or she will fill the water in that small beautiful pot. So Ramesh Bhai said, "Okay." Now every day Bindya fills water using this small pot. Bindya, the daughter of Ramesh Bhai, she was every day filling that pot with water, and one day the pot slipped from her hands and it fell down and broken into pieces. One day by mistake, the pot slipped down from her hand, from the hands of the Bindya, and that pot broke down into small pieces because it is made up of clay. So heartbroken Bindya collected the pieces and kept them behind the house. Then after she collected that pieces of that broken pot, and she kept those pieces behind the house, or you can say in the open area. So the grandfather now asked to Jill that, "Now tell me dear, what would you have happened to those pieces?" what would happen to those species of this small pod which is made up of clay? So now you answer me that what would happen to those small pieces of the pod. So after some days those species will also mix with the soil. Why? Because they are also made up of clay. So that's why after some days they will also mix with the soil and they will convert it into the small pieces, or you can say small particles. So here now Jill is answering to her grandfather that some girls like me must have used them for playing games, replied Jill. Some girls like Jill are using those pieces to play the different games. Maybe you are also using the pieces of pots for the different games. So Jill is also using those kind of pieces to play the games. So now grandfather is saying that you are correct. These pieces are mixed again with the soil. You can also use them to play the different games. And after some days, these pieces are mixed again with the soil, because they that is made from soil only. Hearing this, confused Jill asks, what other things get mixed in the soil? Now Jill is getting confused that the pieces of the pod is mixed with the soil. Now what are the different things that might be mixed with the soil? So you answer me, what are the different things you can see in the soil or that can mix in the soil? So we already know that the paper, after some days paper can also mix with the soil. Then after the decaying matter, or you can say vegetable etc., like vegetable peels, that can also mix with the soil after some days. Then after leaves, dry leaves of the plants, animal excreta, human excreta, those things are also can mix with the soil after some days. And from that we are also preparing the manure, which is useful in the farms to the farmers. So these all are things are can get mixed into the soil after some days. This time duration is different from the for the different objects. So this is the story about Maganbhai and his granddaughter Jill. So now let me start the chapter. Here in this starting one activity is given to you. So now let me see this activity. For that first, what you need to perform this activity, you can perform this activity at your home also. First you need spade. You know that what is spade? To dig in the farm we are using this spade, which looks like this. Spade look like this. So this one is the spade which is used to dig in the farm or to dig the garden. Next we require sieve for sieving wheat. Sieve you already have seen at your home. This one is the sieve. There is the sieves, different kinds of sieves are available with different sizes. That means here the holes are there. The size of the hole is different for the different kinds of sieve. Here you have to take the sieve for sieving the wheat. Your mother, if you had seen, your mother is sieving the wheat to separate the wheat and the husk of the wheat. Husk, that means outer covering of the wheat. Sometimes the wheat, outer covering of the wheat, then after big stone particles are also there with the wheat. So to separate them, we are using this sieve, or this method is known as the sieving. So here you have to take sieve, which is useful for the sieving wheat. Next, one another sieve also you require, that is sieve for sieving wheat flour. Another sieve, it has the smaller holes as compared to this sieve. Smaller holes by which you can sieve the wheat flour. Then you need the thin cotton cloth and lumps of the soil, or you can say bigger piece of the soil. So these are the things you need for this activity, spread to different kinds of sieve. That is one for sieving the wheat and one sieve for sieving the wheat flour. Another thing you need is a thin cotton cloth, and last one, lumps of soil. Now first here, in the first activity, what you have to do? Take one lump of soil, turn it into small particle size and sieve it through the wheat sieving sieve. That means from the first sieve, which has the bigger holes as compared to the second one. From that sieve, you have to like this. You have to sieve the soil particles from these lumps or big piece of the soil. You have to first break that piece of soil, and then after you have to sieve the soil using this sieve. And then you have to observe what is left in this sieve and observe and note here. Here in this table we have to note down. Here in this sieve you will find the bigger particle, and here from down the smaller particles, or you can say fine particles, will be sieved out from this sieve. So sieve soil through the wheat sieving sieve. Keep the components left in the sieve separately. Here in the sieve, whatever you are getting, that you have to keep separately. So here now in the table, you have to answer that what is left in the sieve. What you hear you will get in this sieve, that you have to write here. And what is sieved out of the sieve? What is sieved out or here and you are collecting from here, that you have to write here. So now let me see the answer for this table. So here the answer is given to you. In the first phase of sieving with wheat sieve, small stones are left in the sieve. Small stones in the soil mixture will stay there, or that will left in the sieve while sieving with the wheat sieve. And what is sieved out of the sieve? So the other components of the soil got sieved out. The rest of the components, that is fine particles, or you can say small particles, like soil, clay, sand, that will got sieved out from this sieve. So this one you have to write in your textbook. What is left in this sieve? So small stones, or you can say bigger stones, in short stones are remain in the sieve, and other components or fine particles are sieved out from the sieve, like sand, clay, etc. Now next, also you have to perform the another activity with the same tools. Here activity number 2. Now here you have to use the another sieve. Collect the sieve part and sieve it with the sieve used for sieving flour. In the first activity, what we had get after sieved out, that is small particles or fine particles. So that mixture you have to take, and that mixture you have to sieve out from this sieve, which is used to sieve wheat flour. Then after you have to observe what is left in this sieve, what is left here in this sieve, and keep the components left in this sieve separately. This component you have to put separately, and here you have to find what you will get after sieve out. So sieve part through the wheat sieving sieve. Here we are taking the mixture which is sieved out from the first activity. So now here also you have to write the observation, what is left in this sieve and what is sieved out of this sieve. So now let me see the answer for this. So here the answer is given to you. What is left in this sieve? So sand is left in this sieve. As now the holes of this sieve is smaller as compared to the first one, so the sand particles, which are bigger than the clay particles, or you can say dust particle, so that is left in this sieve. Now what is sieved out of this sieve? So fine powder of soil is sieved out of this sieve. Very fine, that means small particles or small particle powder which contains the small particles of the soil is sieved out from this sieve. So this one you have to write in the table of activity number 2. Now next is what to do with the fine cloth or fine cotton cloth. So here for that, next activity number 3 is given to you. Collect the second time filtered soil, that means the mixture which is sieved out from the second activity. So that you have to take the sample, and that means the filtered soil, that was the filtered soil from which we had removed the sand particles and stone, and then sieve that mixture through the cotton piece like this. Here we are putting the mixture which we get from the activity number 2. And then after we have to sieve that mixture with the help of the cotton cloth. And what is, you have to observe what is left in the cloth and also observe the filter component and not. Here you have to observe what is left in the cotton cloth and after sieving what we are getting. So sieve soil through the cotton piece and separate the component of component left in the cloth from those filtered from the cloth. And these two mixture you have to put separately. So now in this table you have to write your observation that what is left in the cloth and what is filtered out of the cloth. What is here, that means left in the cloth, and what is filtered out from the cloth. So now let me see the answer for that. So here the answer is given to you. That silt is left in the cloth. Silt, that means very fine particles of clay, or you can say sand or dust. So that silt is left in the cloth and fine powder of soil is filtered out of the cloth. Fine particle is separated out and silt, that means very small, very fine particles of the soil is left in the cloth. So this is the difference between these two, that is silt is left in the cloth and fine particles of the soil, that means dust, we will get after sieving with the cotton cloth. So this you have to write in your textbook. So here our first activity gets over, that is separating the components of the soil. So here observation is given to you, observe the filter and left our components for first, second and third time. For the first time, when we are sieving with the sieve which is used to separate the or which is used to sieve the wheat, in that case we are separating the soil from the bigger pieces of soil, or you can say from the stones. In the second case, when we are sieving with the sieve which is used to sieve the wheat flour, in that case we are separating the soil mixture from the sand, or we are separating soil from sand from the soil mixture. And in the last case, we are separating silt, that means little bit the size of the particles is little bit bigger than the dust and smaller than the sand. So we are separating the silt from the dust. And at the end, we are getting very fine, that means very thin particles of the soil, which is also known as the dust. So these are the observations from the first, second and third case of this activity. Now think and say that which components are obtained after sieving the soil with different size sieve cells. So which components we are getting? So in observation we had already written, after sieving the soil with different size of sieve, we are getting stones, sand, then after clay particles, or you can say soil particles, dust, silt, etc. Next is, can there be any other components present in the soil? So yes, there can be any more than these components. There are also some other components in the soil like water particles. You had seen that if you are touching the soil, some of the soil feel wet. So that means the water particles in the form of moisture is also present in the soil. Other than that, dry leaves of the plants are also there, or dried some parts of the plants are also there. Some microorganisms are also there, like earthworms are also there in the soil. And other than that, some organic material, or you can say organic matter, like animal and human excreta are also there in the soil. Next is, how do the amount of different components affect the type of soil? So yes, the amount of different components will affect the different size, different type of the soil. Like if we had collected one sample, or if we had taken one sample in which the amount of sand particles is more as compared to the other components, then that soil is known as the sandy soil. And if the amount of clay particle is more as compared to the rest of the components, then that soil is known as the clay soil. So this is how the different components, or the amount of different components, will define the type of that soil. the answer. You have to think about this. Next activity number 4 is given to you. That we will study in our next video. So in this video till now we have seen about the different components of the soil. We have seen that with the help of one activity in which we had sieved or we had separated the different components of the soil with the help of this sieve. And from that we can conclude that soil is made up of many different particles or many different components like stones, soil, or you can say clay, sand, dust, silt. Other than that, water, moisture, organic matters like human and animal excreta, or some parts of the or some dead or decaying parts of the animals or microorganisms or earthworms. Microorganisms, that means all the organisms which we cannot see by our naked eye. So those kind of organisms are also present in the soil. Other than that, dry leaves and some dry parts of the plants are also there in the soil. So these all are the components of the soil. The next part or the remaining part of this chapter we will study in the next video. Thank you.